A country with a population of more than 33.8 million inhabitants, Morocco, known as the Sustainable Kingdom, is a country bordering the Atlantic Ocean and the Mediterranean Sea, which is distinguished by its Arabian and European cultural influences. The North African nation shares borders with Algeria on the north and Mauritania on the south. As a first-time visitor, through my observation, I could say that it is one of the most organized and civilized Arab nations in the world. Looking at the current trend in the Arab world, Morocco is politically stable and the most peaceful Arab countries with no reported news of violence or unrest, thus making it the most preferred tourist destination in North Africa. And according to the King of Morocco, His Majesty King Mohammed VI assured delegates at the recently concluded COP22 conference in Marrakesh that Morocco will be the number one tourist destination in Africa by 2025. The unit of the Moroccan currency is called the Moroccan dirham, which has the well-sculpted face of the king printed on it and can be used in purchasing goods around the country. Beautifully grown and shaped pineapple trees can be seen visible in the main highways and everywhere around the city, adding to the beauty of the country's glittering landscape, giving it that top-notch look that you can't resist. Unlike the Gambia, Morocco has two official languages, which includes Arabic and Amazigh Berber. The classical Arabic is the main language used for education and administrative purposes, while everyday conversation is in the local dialect called Darija. As a result of Morocco's openness to the rest of the world, French and Spanish are two languages practiced daily by millions of Moroccans. English is also a very common language spoken in the country's international cities such as Marrakesh, where I visited, Casablanca and Tangier. Islam is the kingdom's main religion. However, there exist Jewish and Christians that practice their religion freely. Morocco is made up of spectacular landscapes with its snowy Atlas Mountains, the dunes of the Sahara, the valleys, the cedar forest and long stretches of Oregon trees, sandy beaches and abundant vegetation that makes it a real paradise for nature lovers like myself, leaving you to fall in love with the country. My cameraman and I visited the Jem Afna market, which is one of the biggest markets in Marrakesh, attracting different kind of people and races across the world.
You're watching us from Jem Afna, Marrakesh, and we have Hamami with us here. Hello.
Yes. Welcome in COP 22 in Marrakesh. Welcome in Morocco.
Can you tell us all the fruits that you have here?
Okay, we have here just figs. This one is figs. The figs from Morocco here, okay, and the production of Morocco, this one. This one is the apricot, okay. Yeah, and the dates. The apricot is the importation from Turkey and Spain, okay, but this apricot, this date.
The market has a lot of stuff on display and activities that one can indulge in, from tattooing to singing, dancing, etc. Due to the confluence of the Atlantic Ocean to the west and the Mediterranean Sea to the north, Morocco benefits from a moderate subtropical climate that attracts the many tourists who visit the country on a daily basis seeking to make adventures. My Marrakesh visit was a mind-blowing experience that availed me the opportunity to interact with people of different walks of life that converged in Marrakesh for the Climate Change Summit, an experience I will forever live to reminisce until I have the opportunity to visit again. Reporting for GRTS News, I am Fatou Janimbay.